Fuego, you know I came through. Hey, you know I came through. You know I came through with the fuego. You know I came through. Hey, you know I came through. Nowadays. Hi class, welcome back to our channel. So for today's topic, we will discuss the minimum essential learning competencies or MELC of our pre-calculus subject. So bakit po natin kailangang malaman yung MELC ng subject natin para alam natin kung ano ba yung mga topic na i-discuss natin kung gusto nating mag-advanced study or balikan yung mga lesson na na-discuss na natin para ma-master nyo siya, ito yung pwede nyong tingnan. Okay? So, dito sa ating MELC, meron tayong limang column. So, yung unang column is the quarter. The second column is the content standard. So, makikita natin dito yung main topic ng mga i-discuss natin na subtopics. Dito naman, performance standards. Ano ba yung dapat na kaya na natin gawin after natin madiscuss tong mga to? Tapos, sa fourth natin, fourth column, yung most essential learning competencies. So, ano ba yung mga subtopics na pag-aaralan natin? Then, sa last column, duration, dito natin makikita kung gaano ba katagal natin dapat i-aral yung specific na learning competencies. So, para sa week 1 natin, yung content standard natin is key concepts of conic sections and systems of non-linear equations. So, performance standard, model situations appropriately and solve problems accurately using conic sections and systems of non-linear equations. So, sa week 1 natin, we will study all about the four different types of conic sections. So, yung mga degenerated conic section natin from a cone. So, dito yun sa module 1, pinakauna. Then, next to that is circle. So, we'll graph a circle given an equation in center radius form. For the week 2 naman is the parabola. So, magagraph tayo ng parabola. Okay? For our week 3 naman is we will also study about ellipse naman. Then, magagraph din tayo ng ellipse. Then, for week 4, magagraph naman tayo ng parabola. So, pag-aaral natin yung mga properties nila dyan ng bawat isa. Then, for week 5, recognize the equation and important characteristics of four different types of conic sections. So, dito sa part na to, aaralin natin kung paano natin malalaman yung equation. Kung circle ba siya, ellipse, or parabola, or hyperbola. Then, for the last topic in week 5, solve situational problems involving conic sections. So, application naman ng napag-aralan natin about conic sections. So, for week 6 naman, illustrate systems of nonlinear equations. So, determine solution of systems of equation 1 linear and 1 second degree in 2 variable substitution by using substitution, elimination, and graphing. So, dito naman, magsusolve tayo ng systems of non-linear equations. Then, week 7, solve situational problems involving systems of non-linear equations. So, application naman, problem solving on the last part. So, yung week 7 natin. And then, for week 8, so, sa week 8, iba na yung content standards natin. So, ito na. An understanding of key concept of series and mathematical induction and the binomial theorem. So, dito naman, sa ating performance standard, should be able to keenly observe and investigate patterns and formulate appropriate mathematical statements. So, dito naman, sa week 8 to 9 natin, ito yung iti-discuss natin. We will study about series. So, differentiate series from a sequence. And then, we will use the sigma notation to represent a series. Then, apply the use of sigma notation in finding sums. So, ito naman. So, ito na yun natin. Okay. So, dito na tayo sa quarter 2. So, quarter 2 contains standards and understanding key on the key concepts of circular functions, trigonometric identities, inverse trigonometric functions, and the polar coordinate system. Then, for our performance standard, formulate and solve accurately situational problems involving circular functions. So, sa week 1 to 2 ng ating second quarter, ito naman yung mga i-discuss natin. Illustrate the unit circle and relationship between the linear and angular measures of central angle in a unit circle. Then, convert degree measure to radian and vice versa. And then, illustrate angles in standard positions and coterminal angles. Yun naman sa week 2 natin. So, for our week 3, illustrate the different circular functions. Use reference angle to find exact values of circular functions. Okay? So, week 4 naman, illustrate the domain and range of the different circular functions. And then, graph the 6 circular function amplitude, period, and phase shift. So, dito sa part na to class, dito natin makikilala si sine, cosine, tangent. So, ayan. So, mag-evaluate tayo ng mga exact values nila. Then, also, mag-graph din tayo. No? For our week 6, ito naman ang performance standard natin. Apply appropriate trigonometric identities in solving situational problems. So, sa week 6 to 8, determine whether an equation is an identity or a conditional equation. Then, apply trigonometric identities to find other trigonometric values. And then, solve situational problems involving trigonometric identities. Ayan. So, for our week 6 to 8. Next, karugtong pa rin nung week 6 to 8 natin, ito naman yung ating performance standard. Formulate and solve accurately situational problems involving appropriate trigonometric functions. So, illustrate, ito naman yung MLC natin doon. Illustrate the domain and range of the inverse trigonometric functions. Then, evaluate an inverse trigonometric expression. Then, solve trigonometric equations. Okay? For week 9, so ito na yung pinakalas natin na week. Solve situational problems involving inverse trigonometric functions and trigonometric equations. Okay, so that's it for our pre-calculator. Ayan, so yun lang para sa ating pre-calculus subject. Yun yung mga pag-aaralan natin. So, I hope excited na kayo to start our discussion in our pre-calculus class. So, kung may natutunan kayo at natuwa kayo sa video na to, just click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell at ilike din ang video na to para updated kayo sa kasunod nating lesson sa ating pre-calculus class.